beautiful people, it's Taobao. If this is your first time watching my video, you're welcome to my channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for stopping by. In today's video, I'm going to be telling you all you need to know about Alibaba or Taobao. Now, I know if you're watching this video, most of you probably would be more familiar with Alibaba unlike Taobao. So in today's video, I'm going to be telling you why you should be using either Alibaba or Taobao, and in what cases you should actually use them for, and how convenient it's going to be for you. Now, I'm going to actually be telling you all this while talking about your differences, because I feel this way you'll be able to understand which one suits me the most. Both Taobao and Alibaba are both Chinese shopping app, where more like AliExpress. So AliExpress is like the English version of Alibaba that's really used across all countries, and you have the app within each country. But the thing about Alibaba is that, unlike Taobao, Alibaba, once you are looking for a kind of way to like get goods from China, want to be an wholesaler, you should try using Alibaba unlike Taobao, because for Alibaba, they sell in bulk mostly. Either you want to talk to the wholesaler or you want to talk to the manufacturer, Alibaba is like the best place for you to get it. And it is quite convenient because it also has the English version. Now, I don't know if you guys know this, but Alibaba has both English version and the Chinese version. Now, the English version is intentionally programmed so as foreigners will be able to use it internationally. But unlike Alibaba, Taobao is mainly more for the Chinese, because the app is entirely programmed in Chinese, and even shipping is really within China. If you want to buy probably a top, or you want to buy 5 different tops, and you want to buy a few shoes and a bag, you just want to upgrade your closet, you should go for Taobao. If you know how to get your goods from China down to wherever you are, but if you are thinking of probably selling to other people, you should go for Alibaba. With Alibaba, you can actually tell the seller to help you ship your goods to wherever you are. If you are in Nigeria, for instance, you can tell your seller to help you ship. But I must say though, because I feel like most people will be having issues with this, if peradventure you are buying multiple goods, of course you can't tell the seller to send each goods like that to the country. You will actually want them together and want it to be shipped or to be sent through flight to wherever you are. Now, in this case, it is best, I suggest it is best to find a warehouse that helps to send goods from China to your own country. For instance, we have a lot of warehouse that send goods from China to Nigeria. So that way, if you are trying to buy things from China to Nigeria, you will buy your things from Alibaba and then send it down to the warehouse. So the recipient's address and number will be the number of the warehouse, and also the phone number of the warehouse. That way, they are going to help you to gather all your goods and send it. In case where you are just getting very few goods, you should try using Taobao. And that way, you would also be able to send your goods to the warehouse to your own country. Now, another difference between Alibaba and Taobao is that things on Taobao most times are quite cheaper to things on Alibaba. That is if you are getting things that are very few. Like I said, okay, now let me give you guys an instance. I'm sure that if you actually downloaded the app, the English version of Alibaba, and you're trying to shop, you will notice that most sellers would write 3 and above. So you can't get 1, you can't get 2. You have to get 3, because Alibaba, like I said, is mostly for bulk purchases. But unlike Taobao, you would be able to get things per 1. But in some cases where on Alibaba, like I said, it is in most cases, there are some goods you would want to buy on Alibaba and you'll be able to buy 1, probably like shoes, like tops and some bag, really, unless like mostly shoes actually, you'll be able to get like per 1. But in most cases, when you weigh the prices from Alibaba's own, the English version most especially, because that's what most foreigners use, to Taobao. It is not outrageously expensive, by the way, but it is a little bit expensive. And you know, for you to be buying things from China, of course you're trying to save every penny. So Alibaba is quite a little bit higher. Don't let me say expensive. Higher, the prices is a little bit higher. I don't want to use expensive or costly to the one on Taobao. But mind you, like I said, Taobao is mainly meant just for the citizens. And another thing, difference between Taobao and Alibaba is, I wouldn't want a situation whereby you guys would be stopped. So in case if you are trying to get refund on Taobao is way more faster to refund on Alibaba. Refund on Taobao is way more faster than refund on Alibaba, because you know, of course, on Taobao, if you are trying to get, especially when you are using Alipay, now let me be clear, especially when you are using Alipay. So when you are using Alipay, it is way more easier to get a refund than using an international card where you'll be paying in dollars. Also on Alibaba, if you are paying using Alipay, you would get a faster refund through that. And another thing about Alibaba is that the English version and the Chinese version, yeah, they are quite similar, but the English version, the prices there are more costlier than the Chinese version because it is in renminbi. But now, if you don't know, renminbi is yuan, Chinese yuan. But if you are buying from the English version, it is a little bit more expensive because then you have to convert it to your rate if it is in dollars. But the Chinese version of Alibaba is cheaper than that of the English version. But one thing I really need to put out there, okay? One thing I really need to put out there is that if you are trying to buy things from China, either using Alibaba, you should think of the reason and if it would pay you. Now, firstly, I said the reason because if you are trying to get something from China and you need it in 5 days, you need to think, oh, if I order this thing, will it be able to get to the warehouse? Or will I be able to get it within 5 days? You have to think if it's actually worth it, because trust me, it is only reasonable for you to buy things from Alibaba when you know 100% sure you will be able to save some money. Now, not penny in this case. If you know you'll be saving some money, for instance, I would not advise you to get, if you want to get, let me say, pots, like kitchen utensils that are quite big. If you are getting, now mind you, using C is all about how big it is, the width and the length, but for air, it is all about the weight. Now, if you are buying pots from China because you feel it is cheaper in China, maybe one pot is like 8,000 from China, and you buy like 5 for your own personal use, is fine. You think of it like, oh, 8 times 5, that is 40. Well, that's 40,000 for 5 pots. You might be thinking it is actually worth it, but you have to always think of the money you are going to spend to clear this goods, and also the shipping fee. Now, the shipping fee is what makes it expensive. So before you buy things from Alibaba or before you buy things on Taobao, you need to think of how well the money you are going to be saving will mean to you, and even to think if it will be really valuable. Because if you are spending 40,000 for a pot that will be sold 70,000 here, and you bought it, the cost price is 40,000, but now shipping it, you are paying close to 60,000 by the time it gets back. You know, it does not pay you. And if you are using C, you have to wait probably like 30 to 40 days, so you know it does not pay you. But when you are getting the best thing, I would suggest, like when you are buying things on through Alibaba, maybe wholesale. Now for wholesale, it doesn't really matter about the size, because you think of it and you add it to the money you'll be selling it to make your own profit. But if you are shopping for your own personal use, buying clothes, shoes and bag from China would be like the easiest, and I would say would really pay you, in the sense that clothes don't really take much space. That way you'll be able to save some money. So buying things from China is not all about, oh, it is cheap. You also have to think of it that sellers would add some money to whatever goods you are buying and also want to make profit. So you have to also put that in mind before buying things from China, and think of the shipping fee to know if or not it is quite reasonable, and if it will be profitable for you as a seller, and even to be profitable for you just as a consumer, and save you some coin. Okay, so that's it for this video. I really hope you guys learned one or two things from it. If you have any other question about shopping from Alibaba or Taobao, let me know in the comment section. I was planning on doing a video where I'll teach you how to use Alibaba, but I just felt there was really no need for it, because you have the English version, so you should just use the English version. And I'll be coming up with more content. Please do like this video if you enjoy it. Subscribe to my channel and let me know in the comment section if you have any question. Trust me, I'm going to be answering you. Probably there are things you need to know but you did not get it in this video. So sorry about that. But please let me know in the comment section. I love you all, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.